Summer is here, school is out, and that means more and more students are going to be on the hunt for internships. But some young professionals are now suing companies for relying on them too much. Channel 4's Erica Rako spoke to an employment lawyer and joins us now with some advice for companies and interns who are looking to avoid a future court date. Erica?
Yeah, well, experts say the best piece of advice for interns and for companies is to have a clear understanding up front before the internship begins if there's going to be compensation, no compensation, and exactly what the intern will be doing. Another useful tool that you should be familiar with is the U.S. Department of Labor's test for unpaid interns.
Whether it's answering phones or running coffee, internships are meant to be a learning experience. But in some recent cases, interns claim they've been taken advantage of, doing much more than coffee runs and for free. One case still in litigation, a former intern suing the Charlie Rose Show on PBS.
They were volunteering to help out the national public broadcasting system, and they were learning a ton. But one of them now has turned around and sued the Charlie Rose Show on the theory that the 25 hours a week that she was spending working there should have been paid.
Many companies require students get college credit for an internship, but employment attorney Bob Riegel warns that's where several employers err.
The wage and hour division takes the position it doesn't matter whether the person's coming through the University of Florida or otherwise. If they're providing a benefit to the employer, if they're doing work for the employer that benefits the employer, then they're entitled to compensation.
The Department of Labor outlines six criteria that must be met for an internship to be legally unpaid. The internship is similar to training given in an educational environment. The internship experience is for the intern's benefit. The intern doesn't displace employees but works under supervision of existing staff. The employer gets no immediate advantage from the intern, and on occasion its operations may actually be delayed. The intern is not entitled to a job at the end of the internship. And the employer and the intern understand the intern is not entitled to wages.
The best example of a pure internship would be a shadowing relationship. So we have a University of Florida first year law student, and she comes in as an intern. She shadows me all day. She doesn't do any work that benefits the law firm.
Riegel says the dangers are the gray areas. In that last example he gave, say he had that intern do an hour of research. Is that an hour of work that he or she should be paid, or is that just a good experience for the intern? So again, he says the best advice is to have a clear understanding between the intern and the company before the internship begins to avoid ending the summer in any legal hot water. Reporting live this morning, Erica Rako, Channel 4, the local station.
Very interesting, Erica. Thank you so much. One of the